Students, we'll see with the type 2 problems now. So what's the question defined is, using convolution theorem, obtain the inverse of the function 1 upon s into a square plus a square. Now we have been given this question, L inverse we have to find using convolution theorem. If you are evaluating from convolution theorem, we are required with two functions, that is f of and g of. So here, try to split the given function into two functions. Here it is a product of two terms in the denominator. So try to split it into two as 1 by s, another one as 1 upon s square plus a square. You can either take this as f of s and this as g of s, or this as g of s and this as f of s. Both are in the same manner. We can evaluate. I told you, once you get f of s, find what is f of t. What is f of t? L inverse of f of s. What is f of s? It is 1 by s. And we know that L inverse of 1 by s is 1. So once you get f of t, find for f of u. Means just replace t by u. Is there any t term over here? No. So this is a constant term, so constant term only will remain. Similarly, I have got g of s. I will find for g of t. What is g of t by definition? It is L inverse of g of s. What is g of s? From the given, it is 1 upon s square plus a square. L inverse of 1 upon s square plus a square, we know that it is sin a t upon a. Hence, this is g of t. I want g of t minus u. So, this becomes, where all t is there, replace it as t minus u. So sin a of t minus u upon a. Do not cancel this a and this a. This is an angle. This is a number. Okay, so don't go to cancel. So hence, multiply this a inside. So it will become sin a t minus a u. That is g of t minus u. Once we get f of u and g of t minus u, now consider the convolution theorem. What is the convolution theorem given? It is L inverse of f of s into g of s is equals to integral u equals to 0 to t f of u into g of t minus u du. F of s is 1 upon s. G of s is 1 upon s square plus a square. So this is your given function. F of u is 1. Substitute here. G of t minus u is sin a t minus a u upon a. This is the integral with respect to u. So, t is acting as a constant and a also. 1 into sin a t minus a u upon a is sin a t minus a u. This 1 upon a will come out. We need to integrate sin function with respect to u. We know that integration of sin ax plus b is always equals to minus cos ax plus b upon a. Coefficient of x will be coming in the denominator. Now in this question, that is in this integral, coefficient of u will come in the denominator. So integration of sin is what? Minus cos at minus au. What is the coefficient of u? Minus a. So right divided by minus a. Limits ranging from 0 to t. This a and this a, it will become a square. This minus and this minus will make it plus. So I am remained with cos a t minus a u, limits ranging from u equals to 0 to t. Means where all u is there, substitute t ones, and where all u is there, substitute 0 ones. What is the upper limit? T. So this becomes a t, right? A t minus a t will become 0. So it will become cos 0, upper limit. Minus the lower limit. 0 into a is 0. So I am remained with cos a t. So the further term I am getting is cos 0 minus cos a t. Hence 1 upon a square is outside. Cos 0 is 1. 1 minus cos a t upon a square is the evaluation for the given problem. Thank you.